one mother, you know, comes to your website. So can you take us through the entire life cycle, so how she gets benefit? Assume that she's already having a small idea.
Mm.
Maybe, for example, let's say pottery. Let's give an example.
Mm.
And then she's very good in pottery, and then they can be used for gifting purposes.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm.
So if somebody, if such lady comes to in connect with you,
mm.
and then she joins your club, and
yes.
then how do you think that you take her from end to end, so that her business, maybe right now, assume that it is X, now it becomes X plus one, let's say 8 months down the line, 5 months down the line.
Yes,
so,
it's
can
happened,
you take us
it's
through
happened.
Event? Sure.
So, to begin with, she has to come for our connect meets.
Okay.
So, we have these offline connect meets that happen. We've
That's,
had.
Once I get connected with you on the Facebook, next stage is the connect meets.
Connect meets we have. The first is the induction that happens. Every month, we have an induction program, induction session on Facebook.
Okay, on the Facebook itself.
On the Facebook, and we have that complete document as to what is there, where, and
mm-hmm.
what else, what are the things that we do.
Okay.
So they're supposed to join, and that document is there. Please go through it if you have
Almost
any
like
questions.
Yeah.
So if you have any other questions, you can
mm-hmm.
connect with us.
Mm-hmm.
Then every week we have some of the, once in a week,
mm-hmm.
every month we have events happening on the forum.
Okay.
Where they can connect with other, they can join in, they can connect with other members. We have inspiring stories, we have expert talks.
So how does it happen again through
the Facebook?
Okay.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So that's the second stage.
So I'm telling you some of the things that she can do. Then every quarterly we have a business over breakfast meet.
Okay.
We meet around 30 women. Is the capacity that we keep because we want to give a presentation about what other things we do.
Right.
So each member gets to present her business, her challenges,
right.
what is it that she's looking for.
Right.
So there itself she's doing a connect, she's forming teams.
And she can also get free advice.
Yes, and she's getting free advice.
Right.
Her products are getting reviewed.
Right.
She gets feedback.
Right. Absolutely.
And not just in Mumbai, we are doing it simultaneously across all our chapters.
Okay.
So she's connecting with like 30.
So how did you go there to all these places?
No, we don't go. It's conducted in different places and we connect over the webinar.
Very good.
So she's automatically made so many new connections.
So it's almost seamless.
Yes. She's automatically made so many new connections.
Right.
And once she's done that,
mm-hmm.
then say if she needs some, through the group only she comes to know whom she can learn from better.
Right.
You know,
mm-hmm.
so that way she can participate and
mm-hmm.
she can take the trainings or mentoring or whatever she needs
mm-hmm.
from within the group.
Right.
If she tells us that, you know, she needs so and so support, she needs some training or mentoring, we help them. And
it's almost like incubating, accelerating, everything put together.
Yes.
A typical entrepreneurship,
yes. They're not alone.
Right.
I mean, we're not alone anymore. I mean, I get the feeling that, okay, I'm not alone. I need something, I can always reach out to her.
Okay,
I've got a party at home, I need serve mocktails. I know I don't have to go to. She's
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
I can get her mocktails.
Right.
I have to give somebody, I have to give my birthday gifts that we give.
Right.
We get it on the forum. And that's like a lady on the forum who just told. She sent me a message saying, you know, MomPreneursindia has become like a one-stop shop for me.
Very good.
I don't have to go anywhere. I just have to post a requirement here that I need so-and-so and I get,
everybody
get it here.
So-and-so.
And that's the underlying agenda, you know, that we are self-sufficient.
Right.
If we just help each other, if we promote each other, we can have sustaining businesses.
Right.
And it's not like there is low quality. If the quality is not good,
how is it going to look?
We automatically get the feedback.
Right,
because
absolutely.
We get the reviews
right.
and we get the feedback and they, you know, they improve.
Okay.
So that's the model.
So one thing that, I mean, out of curiosity is what I'm asking is, now that you have interacted with these people for almost about 5-6 months now, and then you're talking about 800 people and across the cities, you have conducted some exhibitions and all that. Just tell me honestly, what do you think is driving this woman? Is it their business side, or is it that, you know, they want to have this achievement? I mean, that happiness, that, yeah, I mean, they're not worried about the scale part of it. Today I might be making 10,000, I mean, today I mean the month wise. Let's say in a month they might make 10,000, next month they might make just about 2,000 rupees. So do they get bogged down with the size of the business, or do you think they get a lot of, you know, fulfillment part of it in this? And yeah, they just want to engage.
The first thing that drives them is their own creative, the need for their own creative, you know, outlet. It is, they are all creative. And
so they're not so much worried about the business side.
They
are.
They are.
Not at the cost of loss as such, but they're okay, I'm saying. So, what I'm saying is, therefore, let's say, today I'll be sending, let's say, I'm going back to the example of pottery kind of thing. So, today this lady would have sold this month maybe about 25 pots and she made about, let's say, $8,000. Next month, she would have made only, she would have sold maybe just about 8 pots and she could have made only just about $1,200.
They're okay with it. They accept it that, you know, something, they do check out for feedback, you know, and they find out reasons. Like, one of the ladies who was, I just want to give you an example. We sent from a lady's jewelry from Bangalore to the Delhi exhibition.
Okay.
And she made like
imitation
jewelry, and she made several pieces and she sent it there, and it didn't sell that well.
Mm-hmm.
So it came back, so she was very disappointed as to, oh, it didn't sell.
Mm-hmm.
There was another lady who said mocktails from here, and those are fresh mocktails, so it has to be consumed in 30 days. So then they didn't sell, and like, so much stock I made, what to do?
Mm-hmm.
So then we conducted a B2B exhibition sale.
Mm-hmm.
On we conducted a B2C on
B2C,
the
absolutely.
Indian Women's
mm-hmm.
Club.
Mm-hmm.
And the mocktails lady, the stock was all sold out there.
Right.
So, you know, they do get like, okay, you know, what to do? And then we think about a solution together. Okay,
right.
let's put this as a part of all our exhibitions from now on,
right.
You know.
Right.
Any exhibitor who exhibits will also get our social media forum.
Right.
So we can always, after a post-exhibition, you can call it like a post-sales, after-sales support, we will let you conduct an exhibition here and sell off your clearance.
But I think over a period of time, all that you have observed, that these people want to have that sense of achievement.
Sense of achievement. That is,
that
you know,
engaged.
They have done, yes.
I'm also giving, like you rightly said, I'm also giving expression to my intense desire to be doing something else
out
of my normal course. That, you know, course in the sense, just being a housewife, maybe mom, maybe wife, maybe a daughter-in-law kind of thing. And then now that I have some talent, I want to just exhibit that. So that's what you observe.
Yes, they're all very creative, and they don't want to go back to their jobs. They want to take care of the family, and they want to do something, and they have a creative spirit in them, and which is why they continue doing what they are doing. They pursue it. And I have seen some of them not faring so well, then they try out something else.
Okay.
There are mothers who are doing like 4 things at a time. You know, these are not all registered businesses or shops or stores.
Exactly.
They are doing that. So trying out 4 things at a time.
Right.
Photography, pottery, craft, all at the same time. So they're managing well, but it's just like I said, they're excelling in their own fields.
Right.
They're trying to do
mm-hmm.
what they can with the given time.
Right.
And all that I want to do through Mompreneurs India is to help them have sustaining businesses.
Right.
They shouldn't close down because there was no support, or that shouldn't be their failure.
Right.
You know, the failure is of the system because we didn't have something like that
Absolutely.
To support
Absolutely.
Them.
Mm-hmm.
So I think with this in place,
so basically it's an ecosystem that you're creating.
Ecosystem, that's the word. I'm trying to build an ecosystem of positive and supportive attitude towards.
It's a house of entrepreneurs.
Absolutely.
In-house, there is one. So
absolutely. I always, in all my connect meets, I'm telling you, the person sitting next to you is not your competitor. He's your teammate.
Exactly.
Giving an example is because. See, if I am a mother and I have a festival coming up, I get a lot of orders.
Mm-hmm.
But I also have to be with my family for the festival.
Absolutely.
So then I am not able to complete my orders.
Mm-hmm.
Then what? It affects my goodwill.
Right.
So what do I do?
I reach out to somebody else.
It is my competitor. I know she is my competitor. She
Fair
does
enough.
It better.
Right.
Or she does it equally good.
Right.
I can pass on the leads to her.
That's
I could do that if I consider her my teammate.
Leave and let live.
Yes. That's what I'm trying to, you know, I keep saying these things in my connect meet that we have to have a supporting and engaging attitude. Yes. Then we can grow together, we can have sustaining businesses.
Right.
There will be ideas coming from all of you all.
Right.
We can do it better.
Very good. Very
so
good. So coming back to the business side of it, in this, you know, 5 months again, what have been your biggest challenges, you know, trying to, you know, you must have started with a beautiful vision, this one, I want this one.
Challenges are plenty, like I said, just because of the fact that right now it's a free forum and the philosophy is so much, we are not used to thinking this way, I think, where, you know, give us gain thing is yet to sink in.
So
both the philosophy and because it's a free forum, that's a bigger challenge. It limits the scale of the initiatives that we conduct. Right now, it is the founders and the co-founders who are all pitching in for the initiatives. So the scale is not not really not very big because it's free. I've dwelled it for a while. I've spoken to some of my friends. The pilot has been very successful. I have dwelled on it, and I have spoken to some of my members. Also, 800 is not 800 members are there. How many are the ones who are actively contributing? We can only help them. So, because those who are passive, we don't even know about their businesses, what they do. So, what can we really do about them? So, it has to be a closed group or a, from the free club service. I'm moving on to the strategic intent, where I think that it has to be
a subscription model or
fee-based
model.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So we could have different type of packages. So we can keep things free for mompreneurs who are not interested in the rest of the things. And we can have some packages where we have, initiatives distributed amongst it.
So I think, again, going back to what you said, I think the two C's, education and also the sales part of it.
Yeah.
So that somebody can get a consulting, somebody can get just the connect.
Absolutely.
So the connect can be the free part of it, but the consulting, the education part of it.
Something.
And also what you said, the after sales or pre-sales service that you want to offer, I think they can all be packaged and monetized.
We'll be thinking as to, we'll be spending some more time on that.
Yeah.
So like I said, it's a milestone now that we're moving ahead. We have achieved so much so far. If you want to grow at this pace, the pace is not really fast enough. People tell me that, what all y'all are doing, man.
Absolutely.
I feel like, this is still not what I really wanted. And I want to make these initiatives more successful.
Right.
So there has to be a little liability and ownership aspect involved
as
well.
Absolutely.
So all this will happen if we convert it, if we restructure it and convert it into a paid club.
Absolutely.
Kind of an
people
arrangement.
People will be more serious.
Thank you. That's what I'm...
anything free.
Anything. That's what they said, anything free has no value. But I think I have proved that there is value even in things that are free.
I think even that if you look back...
But the ownership liability part is missing.
Because if you look at even Facebook, for example, I think it's free in one sense. But then imagine how could it become $1 billion industry by itself, Facebook, because the kind of ecosystem that is created. And therefore it is helping people to understand better through a lot of analytics.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
Yeah.